sleeping with my ribs touch. Now I get it and go.
Today, from Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, it's week 14 of the NFL on EA Sports. Cincinnati Bengals taking on the Dallas Cowboys.
With the Ohio River and the hills of Kentucky just to our right, we welcome you into Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, Ohio. The enthusiasm of this Cincinnati crowd in full effect a moment ago as their Bengals took the field to the delight of this sold-out crowd. And they're all set as they'll match up with the Dallas Cowboys. Hi again, everyone. I'm Brandon Gunn. To my left, Charles Davis. And Charles, you focus on this Bengal team entering play. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense.
Third down is Burrow, and he will go down, a Cowboys sack.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. Here's Tommy Townsend on to punt. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Fair catch called for and taken right near the 30-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. So out come the Cowboys under head coach Mike McCarthy. And out will come the leader of this offense, and that, of course, is their signal caller.
Well, he did go 2-2 in the last ball game. Well, actually, he went 2-2-1, with the one being the victory.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line there. But wasn't it funny at practice? He threw one when we were watching through an interception, and the defense got on him a little bit, good-naturedly. But they're letting him know, you got to cut down those interceptions. We can't bail you out all the time.
Yeah, two touchdowns, two picks. But as you said, they got the win in that effort last week.
It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4. At the 37-yard line.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Elliott. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down.
It's a gain of 3. Brings up 3rd.
Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And he's got the first down as he's up to the 45-yard line.
Ezekiel Elliott, the ball carrier.
He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
To throw now on 1st down, and now he'll tuck it and run. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield. Those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taking off with it. What a big-time pickup on that play.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Elliott, about 3 yards there to the 27.
Ezekiel Elliott.
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7.
At the 27-yard line. A 3-yard pickup.
The give is to Elliott.
Seven.
And he is going to be close to a first down as the tackle made at the Bengals' 18-yard line. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Able to hit his target, Lamb. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line.
To C.D. Lamb. A gain of 5 brings up 2nd and 5.
They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop it behind the line. A loss on that play, and now 3rd down gets tougher. 3rd and 6. They went with the run-pass option, and I don't know if the option really mattered there because the defense was ready.
So many times you put the defense at a disadvantage because you have those multiple options, but when they read their keys and play it correctly, sometimes the result goes in their favor.
So it's 3rd and 6, and this will be the 8th play of the drive. Back to throw. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. The screen good for 6, but it's not enough as it leads to a 4th down. Instead of throwing it downfield, Charles, they just tried to dump it underneath there. Do you like the call?
I do. I think it's a high percentage play because you get the completion, and what you're counting on is your back to use his legs and his elusiveness to make people miss and pick up the first down. In this case, it didn't happen.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on 4th and inches. They'll run it with Elliott. They only get a hard-fought yard, but that's all they needed. It pays off, the decision to go for it. 1st and goal.
1st and goal, Dallas.
Now Elliott. And the Cowboys are going to be set up with a 1st and goal. He couldn't quite reach the chalk, but they'll have it at the 1-yard line. That's a gain of 7, and we'll leave them with 2nd and goal coming up.
Someone's looking fresh, and this O-line is definitely licking their chops.
And this time, he is in.
Yes.
Ezekiel Elliott with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Oh,
remember
yeah.
What he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and Greg continue Zuerlein that in this one.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-0 Cowboys. That one in the books as a 12-play drive. And it culminates in a touchdown run by Ezekiel Elliott. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
The Bengal offense on their way out as we look at the playoff race in the AFC. And I tell you, 4 weeks still to go, and everything is wide open, and it's fun.
And I know we always talk about, well, if the playoffs were to begin today, and then we kind of go, okay, but they're not. Let's see how it plays out. Wouldn't it be fun to play with this playoff lineup right now?
Because and the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack.
Joe Burrow's sack.
Antoine Woods able to record his fifth sack of the season. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's second and 15. Now it's Burrow. And the catch made, it's Tyler Boyd. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A gain there of 21 yards.
First and 10 at the 41-yard line.
Try a jet sweep here with Higgins. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
The tackle made just shy of midfield. 8 yards on the pickup, brings up second and two.
Now Burrow to throw on second down. Rush coming and he's taken down.
Joe Burrow's sack. By Randy.
That's three sacks now. That's not much of a surprise to me, nor should it be to you. This team, they lead the league in sacks.
Yeah, they do. This is something that we are starting to witness time and time again. Third down, a nickel formation here defensively. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And that is incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
It's a 39-yard punt, three on the return. And let's gaze our attention on Ezekiel Elliott. A tough challenge here in this one. We'll see if he can duplicate the numbers on your screen that he put up last week, up over 100 and a touchdown.
We were watching tape to prepare for this game. One thing you noted that I totally agree with, great complimentary piece in the last game. You know, they're able to throw it pretty well. He ran it exceptionally, and they hope to continue that same formula in this game.
Complimentary with an E, not an R.
That's my English teacher right there.
No gain on the play there. Second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. 11 yards there. First down.
11 on the play. First down, Dallas.
They'll run with Elliott. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32.
Ezekiel Elliott.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up seven.
They'll drop to throw.
At the 32-yard line.
And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. Geno Atkins gets him for a loss of eight. What great push up front. Tell you what, he did not have much time there to scan the field before he was ducking and covering.
Did it appear to you, as it did to me, that the defensive front won their play really quickly? Meaning the guys in front of him had almost no chance to block him. They were on him in a hurry.
And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw.
And he'll go underneath here to Elliott.
And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32, and obviously well short of the first down. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down.
Well, that's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
So on fourth down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. And the win last week punted 4 times as this one's away. This will be fielded at the 17. So a good punt, but a solid 12-yard return. And the Bengals will take over here first and 10. Here again comes Joe Burrow and the offense for the Bengals. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with a quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. The numbers for Mixon last week, 16 carries, 93 yards.
And they've got a nice scheme going right now, and they run the football pretty well. In fact, I was talking with him on the field before the game, and he said he's starting to hear from the guys ahead of him on the rushing yardage total, and they want to know if he's going to jump up there and join them at the top of the list.
Joe Mixon on the carry. The tackle made by Jalen Smith. It's a gain of 7. Brings up 3rd.
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last 2 possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
Mixon with a first down carry. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line.
Mixon, the ball carry.
Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
4-yard line. 1-yard gain. Brings up 2nd.
And now they will throw it with Burrow. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39.
Back at the 39-yard line.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports.
Cowboys 7, Bengals nothing.
Now the Bengals on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. This pass complete to Higgins. And they will get this across midfield, but still well short of the first as he's dropped at the 46.
7. It's 4th down.
Here's Tommy Townsend now as he's on to punt for Cincinnati. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. Zeke and the Cowboys ready to begin their next drive. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the 2nd quarter.
And he doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back. And that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend. 10th carry now for Elliott. And he'll take this one only up to about his 13-yard line.
Holding offense.
You gotta be kidding me.
That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
And he'll take this one up to about the 13.
Ezekiel Elliott.
And that's a gain of six on the first down run.
Brought down by Von Bell. A six-yard pickup. Brings
on second down now. Italia. Oh, an absolutely filthy juke. He's got some space now. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. That run's successful in large part because they had a lot of extra help blocking up front.
Yeah, you've got guys who can do that very, very well. In addition, they can catch the football. So sometimes when they line up with three tight ends, it's not necessarily to run it. And that gives you an advantage when you do decide to barrel off the line of scrimmage and block people downfield.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Rolling to his left. And he's going to keep it here. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
Stat carry by Elliott. And across midfield he goes and into Bengal territory. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and two at the 47-yard line.
A give to Elliott. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
First down, Dallas.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. And this is a rocket pulled in by Cooper, complete.
Amari Cooper.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Second and two at the Bengals.
Off the option, he'll try and run with it. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
It's a gain of 3.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. It'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 17. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. What a play. The big man comes up with the interception. Puts together, Charles, a nice little return, too.
Yeah, he's not going to make anybody forget Darryl Green or Rod Woodson, but look at him lug that thing. He decided it was his. A lot of people might have thought about lateraling it there. No shot. Trying to take it the distance.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. So far, they've had 3 drives, 3 punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out on the field. Now, sometimes, if you have a game where neither side has scored, 3 punts isn't a bad thing. But when you're trying to set the pace, get up on top in a game, you've got to show better offense and find a way to put some points on the board.
A gain of 6 there on first.
Let's just break this down and make it pretty simple. Key to the drag route, letting the play develop, finding the hole in the defense, and giving your athlete, yes, athlete, a chance to make something happen once he has the ball in his hands.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. Burrow looking to pass. Slant pass to Boyd. And he'll go down at the 28. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. From the gun, a give to Mixon. And he'll get about 4 as he's brought down at the 24. And now it looks like we've got a Cowboy shaking up down there on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys' 15-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
And a good pickup there by Mixon, and that shows the talent that he has. Back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons, fourth in the NFL in 2018, ninth last year. But I look for those numbers to jump back up again with the introduction of new talent in Cincinnati.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Tackle made at the 9-yard line. It's a pickup of 6. Brings up 2nd and 4.
Now Joe Mixon. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be 3rd down.
He's tackled at the 7-yard line. It's a gain of a yard.
From the shotgun, it's Burrow.
And 2.
And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line.
Joe Burrow.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
Now Aldrick Rosas for the field goal attempt. From the left hash, this from 37. Rosas' kick is good.
The kick is.
And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
Bengals 3.
So good kick there to polish off the drive with 3 points.
Yeah, coaches always talk about finishing a drive with a kick. 2 of them give you points, either an extra point or, in this case, a field goal.
Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Ezekiel Elliott gets ready to go again here on offense as he shuffles onto the field. And he's well on his way to a 100-yard game. He's already more than halfway there. We're only in the 2nd quarter.
And what I've always loved about running backs is they'll tell you, I had no idea how many yards I had.
Right.
Those guys have an innate sense of where they are in a ball game and how many yards they've accumulated, because you know they're always working towards 100.
He's been working well towards 100 here. And give him 4 yards there, it'll be 2nd and 6.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Opted to run for it. The decision a good one. Picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble. The last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
First down, Elliott, and 3 yards there, takes him to the 45.
The handoff to Ezekiel Elliott. He was brought down at the 45-yard line.
Here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. The Cowboys on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. The ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Intended for his.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Comes the Cowboys punter as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. He'll get off a fairly short kick here as this is toward the sideline. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20. Cincinnati set to take over once again. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. And they're able to get this one across the 35. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. This is Mixon on the draw, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Joe Mixon.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
38-yard line. A gain of a yard. Brings up
on the run, it's Mixon. Dances by him, and the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line.
On the carry. He was taken down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
And the Bengals on third down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. Here's Burrow. And that is incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact. But in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
The Bengals bring out their punter now as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Yards on the punt, return of 4, and that will come the offense as they take over. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and give these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up 2nd and 5.
They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And he's able to get out to the 32. Brought down there.
The ball carrier.
7 yards there and a first down.
Josh Bynes. A gain of 7.
Here's Elliott. And some room to maneuver. And this is going to be a Cowboys first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
He was brought down by
2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score.
First down, Cowboys.
And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Now this throw caught left side. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. 2nd and 10. A very chilly day here, but no snow. And I got to say, if it's going to be this cold, I want snow. You should see Charles' face. He's looking at me like I'm crazy. 11 yards there, first down.
It's funny when I go back to our pregame meeting with Amari Cooper and we mentioned, what if they play man coverage against you? He almost seemed offended by it, didn't he?
I'll beat it. That's basically what he said, right?
I mean, the best receivers we've ever...
Blitz coming and down he goes.
Josh.
Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. As they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. The Cowboys going to use their 2nd timeout now. As the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. 9th play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on 3rd and long. shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Geno Atkins in there to get him for a loss of three, and it will be fourth down.
I don't know about you, but if I'm the offensive line coach right now, I'm having an absolute fit. This team that they're going against has three sacks, yet they rank dead last in the league in sacks coming into this game.
Maybe overlooked them a little bit?
Could be. I don't know if it's the scheme. I don't know if they've just gotten fortunate along the way. I have no real great answer for it, but we're seeing something you don't often see.
A 54-yard attempt.
And that is no good. Oh, he missed it just wide of the upright. And this score will stay right where it is.
Cowboys 7, Bengals 3.
This is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over at the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
He finds his running back, Mixon. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half.
Field goal, a 67-yard attempt.
And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, we'll get back to you and Charles in a bit. But first, let's get to some of these scores around the NFL here in a busy Week 14. We'll begin up north at MetLife Stadium over in New Jersey. And it's the Cardinals who are out in front in that one. DeAndre Hopkins, a touchdown reception. From there, we'll head down to Charlotte to check on the Panthers at home at Bank of America Stadium. And they've got the lead over the visiting Denver Broncos. Christian McCaffrey has a touchdown there. Lastly, we head to the Gulf Coast and check on the Bucks at home in Tampa. And it's the visiting Minnesota Vikings who are out in front. Kirk Cousins has thrown a touchdown pass. Meanwhile, in our game, not a lot of offense to go around. 7-3 is our score. Will we see things open up in the second half? To find out, we get it back to our guys in the booth, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, and he opted for the touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Second half starts with a carry by Elliott. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
Back to throw now on first down. On the move to his left. That's going to go as a loss of six, and it'll set him back for second down.
Brought down back at the 32.
Quick slant as the throw's complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The 25 yards there on the catch and run.
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake at the line of scrimmage. Got right into his route. And the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. A 20th carry here for Elliott. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
And that's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield. He's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
They run the option on second down. Give him three on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
A three-yard pickup. And it's third down.
Able to hit his target, Lamb. And he'll get this only to about the 38 as they stop him a few yards shy of the line to gain.
Well, if you do read man covers, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And this won't get there, won't be online either. It's no good, off to the right, and this score will stay right where it is.
Seven, Bengals three.
So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive or a touchdown.
And he's going to be swallowed up, sacked back at the 45-yard line. DeMarcus Lawrence in there to get him, sack number 14 for him on the year. He was trying to keep his eyes downfield. Nobody came open.
He's trying to do everything that he had been taught, right? Every bit of the technique. But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
Here's second and 10. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. Taken in by the tight end, Doyle.
Burrow.
That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
A gain of two. Brings up third and 9.
They're passing here. Joe Burrow. And that will be incomplete.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
At their own 19.
And let's gaze our attention on Ezekiel Elliott. He's been a good workhorse. I know we use the word workhorse a lot, but he's been a good workhorse for him in this one.
No doubt about it, and there's nothing wrong with that. That's what you're looking for if you're a back, because that means everything's coming together for you. Big guys up front have created space. You've run through it. You've probably got some help even from the wide receivers who want to catch passes as opposed to block, but they're helping out too.
Yeah, everyone's pitching in. He's had a good game.
Jarwin. Incomplete. It's now second and 10.
On second down, Elliott. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Gain on the play.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Step, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Pratt, the quarterback is sacked.
Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure it out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest ones, maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Out now comes the Cowboys punter. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Fair catch called for and made, but now we'll have to see about the penalty.
Personal foul. Roughing the kicker. Defense.
Come on. Trailing here in the second half, went for the aggressive play, got a little too aggressive.
You've got to know when to pull up, or if you're going to go for it, how to take your body across a punter's body and not into him. Not a good play at all.
This is Elliott. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage. But you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
They go to Elliott again. And he'll get about four across the 30 to the 32.
Elliott again, the ball game.
A nickel look now for the Bengals as they try to stop him here on third down.
And it's third down.
Got a man and he hits him in stride. And a good job on the tackle there as they get him down shy of the first on the 35-yard strike.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
And the punt team on now as this one's sent away. I'm going to call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some.
And he will go down, a Cowboys sack. Antoine Woods in there to get him, and that is sack number six now for him on the year.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and it can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
On second down, Burrow. This one grabbed by A.J. Green.
Burrows,
they get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
A gain of 14 yards. Brings up third.
Third and two, now Burrow. And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. Randy Gregory racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
And that's the second sack of the game, but this player, disruptive in all phases, whether he's going upfield, coming underneath, you name it. He's a big-time guy you have to block.
The Bengals bring out their punter now as they're forced to kick for the sixth time today. Uses the stiff arm. It's a 47-yard punt, return of six. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Second and three. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Elliott. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
Second and 11. On play action, they'll throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 37.
A gain of 16 yards. First down, Cowboys.
Shotgun. He'll look to throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete.
The pass.
No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
That's a nice job defensively to make sure everyone was accounted for, because ordinarily you pick up the guys downfield and sometimes you forget about the running back. In this case, they did not and dropped him for no gain.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Out to his left. He'll run it. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. Carl Lawson able to record his fifth sack of the season.
I think normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. What, he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line.
Partner, when you see a screen pass and the defensive tackle ends up making the play, you know that one wasn't sold well at all, because he should be upfield by the time you throw the pass. If not, you end up with big trouble, as we just saw right there.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Now he's flushed out right. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. An incredible play there. They do get big yardage, but they're still stopped a yard or two short, and it's fourth down.
On that play, as you saw the route start to develop downfield, I got the sense that maybe the run would set up for him, and he took full advantage of it and got a big gain on a busted play.
Cowboys trot out Greg Zuerlein.
A 27-yard attempt.
Zuerlein's kick is up and through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3.
Cowboys 10, Bengals 3.
So they've put together a good little drive there, but ultimately stalling out in the red zone.
Yeah, I know a lot of people look at it as a little bit of a negative. They didn't get 6 points out of it, right? Didn't get the touchdown. But that's actually okay. They got 3 points. It will give their defense a little bit of rest, let them settle down over there. So all in all, to me, that's a good drive.
Over first and 10.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Able to find Higgins. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
A gain of 5. Brings up second and 5.
From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. He's got Jack Doyle. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. Catch number 40 for him on the year. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 40-yard line.
They'll run here with Mixon. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there.
Joe Mixon.
We'll call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Jalen Smith. No gain on the play. Second and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. Back now in Cincinnati. It's the Bengals. They've got the football, but they trail here as we get rolling in quarter number 4. Second and 10. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. Middle of the field to the tight end, Doyle. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 39. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
Like the design that we're seeing right there, this is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Now it's Burrow. That's taken in by Higgins. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4, second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling him almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Third and 2.
They'll run with Mixon. Mixon with a first down and more. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Joe Mixon, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Bengals are an extra point away from tying up this football game. So they went to the ground game on third, hoping to pick up the first. They also picked up a touchdown.
Offensive linemen so used in this situation to having to pass block. All right, you're looking at what it is, third down. They don't care that it's third and whatever. They figure they're going to throw the ball. And when you call a running play, I think you energize them. I think you juice them up because I haven't met offensive linemen yet that likes to pass block more than they like to run block. And they opened up some nice holes there for him, and he took it to the house.
Aldrick Rosas on for the extra point. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it all culminated in the touchdown run coming from Joe Mixon. As the kick's away. Now Pollard. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
Pollard on the return. The Cowboys take over first and 10.
Cowboy offense heading out. Let's take a look at the playoff picture coming into the weekend in the NFC. And for them, it's no longer a question of will they make the playoffs. They've clinched the division title. The question, can they hold on to that number one seed?
And this is where the mental fortitude comes to play, doesn't it? Because now you're not just the coach talking about it. It's team talking about it to each other, supporting each other, carrying each other along, because having that number one seed means everything in the NFL.
It does. So even though the division title's clinched, shouldn't take the foot off the gas.
No, not at all. Play it all the way through, and I think we've seen that in recent years in the NFL. The teams that play and play to win each and every game, they're the ones to deal with in the playoffs.